Oh, wow. You know what? I think I'm going to invest in buying myself a studio, because the week before, everything was all right. And then it went wrong. And just as I was pressing the button tonight, pear-shaped. No. So I think we're ready. I think we're all there. Our guest has not appeared just yet, but I'm sure she won't be long. It is the Late Tonight Show. Good evening. I'm hoping to press the right. We've got new software and new toys. Look here. So if you're joining us on Flashback Radio, good evening. If you're joining us on YouTube, on Twitch, on Facebook, a very good evening to you. We've got a chat thing that's working now, so you can chat amongst yourselves, and we'll have a look at the messages in just a moment. But if I press this, I'm hoping that the show will start. Nope, that's not the one. Try this one.
I think we're ready.
Welcome to the Late Tonight Show, starring Pete Sheriff, with our very special guest, Rozalla. And we look at the crazy Christmas holiday gifts. And now, live from Solihull, just outside Birmingham, just off the A45, please welcome your host, Pete Sheriff.
Yeah, that worked. Look, fantastic. Good evening, welcome to the show. This is the Late Tonight Show. My name is Pete Sheriff, and we're here. We've got a fantastic guest coming up in a few minutes' time. Rozalla will be here talking to us about her life, her career, and all that stuff. We've also got Matt Bullock coming on a little bit later on. He's told me he's not coming on until 20 to 9. Thanks for that. Thanks, Matt. Thanks very much. Pete Gibson is around as well. He's doing the production thing in the back. He's right back there somewhere in the studio depths of Flashback Radio. If you're joining us and you're wondering what the hell's going on, we're live on the radio, all right? And now, if for those of you who are of a certain age, you will remember James Whale used to do a very similar thing on TV, on proper telly, where he would be on the radio and on telly at the same time. And this was a thing that people couldn't quite understand at the time, because it was the mid-80s, really, and no one could kind of get their head around what was happening. So I thought, I know what I'll do. I'll try and do the same thing and see what happens, see whether it works. And the technology, let me tell you, the technology, I've got things balancing tonight. I've got like a camera balancing on there, because let me give you a bit of advice, right? Don't use a GoPro to do live streaming. It don't work. I've tried everything. New batteries, new charger. I think this thing has just given up the ghost tonight, because it went. And then Pete went, your picture's gone off. Ah, you see? I told you, I got stuff balancing everywhere. You can see. Oh, man, it's just nuts. Now, if you want to get in touch, look at that. That's a wobbly picture. If you want to get in touch and you want to come and now, will that stay? Won't it? I might have to call downstairs in a minute and ask for some sellotape to keep that where it's supposed to be. Now, if you want to get in touch tonight, you can by a number of different ways. I have to click this now. Look, you see, I've got other things to play with here. Captions. If I press captions. I think our guest is here. Thank the Lord, she's come to save the day. If I press captions, you can get in touch. You'll see the number appear here on screen. It's 0121 318 8688. And that gets you through to us here in the studio. Wherever you are across the planet and across the world, you can get in touch if you use the +44 if you're outside the UK. We're happy with that. And I can stop sweating now because our guest is here, which is fantastic. So I'm going to let her get ready and go and get into position. And I'm going to play some of Rozalla's hits. If you don't know who Rozalla is, or you've just passing by and you're wondering what the hell's going on, this is who we're talking about.
Rozalla!
That little X Factor thing going on there. Hello, Rozalla, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Oh, we're very well, thank you. Thank you for coming on to the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So I was panicking because I was trying to get you on my iPhone and it's saying whatever's not supported. I went, oh! And it said it's only going to work on a laptop. Like Chrissy went to go buy his laptop and he helped me. So sorry for the delay and sorry for making you sweat.
No problem. I don't mind sweating over you. It's fine.
Excellent.
So how are you? Are you okay? How's lockdown been for you? Has it been okay?
It's been very strange, Pete. It's been so weird. Yeah. But we've been months in now and it is what it is. You know, what to do, just take care of yourself.
Yeah. You've been successfully, by the sounds of it, managing to make some music while lockdown's been going on.
Yeah, well, you know, I've been working on an album for the past, I guess you could say, 2 years. We released Turn on the Light probably 18 months ago, 2 years ago, which just carried on doing well and well. We had about 600 stations that playlisted it. You know, so Gary at Energize said, just keep letting it run. And then we released Magnificent deep in the heart of lockdown about the 4th of May this year. So although it sort of raised a profile and did okay, I have to say something interesting, Pete. It was a little difficult because there were no DJs to send it out to.
No, sure. Absolutely. Just relying on the radio stations.
Yeah, so that impacted how, I guess, well it could have done. So, it caused something. It kept the profile, and we weren't able to shoot a video, stuff like that, you know. And then we decided, you know, moving forward, we released this other new track called I Feel It Slipping Away. And before Lockdown 2 came in, Ash Stanley said, we got to do a video. So we all dashed down to Derby. He's got this massive studio, and there were just the three of us in there, you know, and... And we managed to do a video for which I'm grateful to Ash, who pushed for it.
I love that video because it's just you. It's just you. And that is great because it's a few sparkly effects. But literally, it's just, you know, there's a little bit of a clip of it there on your intro. But I do have another clip of it here so people can hear it. But obviously, we have to keep it real because we get copyright strikes from all over the place. So... I'm going to play a little bit of it and let people hear it. That is a proper poppy dancey song. That is you've done it right there. Is that the GMT mix, that one?
That is a GMT mix, and I have to tell you something how this song came about, Pete. Phil, what's his name, from PWL, you know, the PWL that used to do Kylie Minogue, Pete Waterman's label. Phil Harding, actually, he was one of the producers, and he's still strong in the studio and stuff like that. And he had this demo, and he's good friends with Gary, and he sent it to Gary, and Gary said, oh, I need to send this to Rozalla because we're working on an album. And he sent this demo. It had never been released ever, and this demo was probably done sometime in the 70s, And and I loved what I heard. And, you know, obviously we put it up to modern times and get mixes and stuff like that. But I could hear the skeleton of the song being so good. And on top of it, I found out that it was written by Lamont Dozier, writing royalty, you know. They used to write for all the Motown greats, Stevie Wonder, Diana Ross, you name it. And I believe, I looked it up, he's about 89. And he personally sent a message a couple of days ago saying how blessed he was that I covered this song and that, you know, Energize Records is doing it as well. And I just really felt so touched by that.
Yeah, it is a it's got soul to it. It's got and I mean that in its most literal sense, not necessarily soul music, but it's got something about it. That hook is fantastic.
Yeah, I think that's down to Lamont Dozier and all the Motown artists. I think it's got a feel of that, and of course, you know, all the other different mixes take it to a different level of sound. But this particular one, it's kept that ingredient for sure.
You get this going on when you.
You got it, yeah.
So let's go back, right back to the very beginning of time, and how, because obviously everybody knows you it wasn't your first single though, was it? Everybody's Free. It wasn't the first single, but. I'm sure it's fair to say it's one of the biggest 90s dance records ever. I mean, it ranks, you know, firmly at a Butlin's gig, for instance. It ranks firmly up there at the one you can play that will take the roof off.
Yeah.
So let's go right back in a bit. How did you start in the business? How did you start singing? How did you get here? Because you're from Zambia, right?
Yeah, I was born in Zambia and I grew up in Zimbabwe, you know, and all my life, Pete, I just wanted to be an international singer. You know, that's all I ever wanted to do from day dot, you know, so it's been in me for practically all my life. And we moved to Zimbabwe. To cut the long story short, I joined a group and we went across the Zimbabwean country, you know, singing covers of other songs that we heard on the radio station, you know, Western songs. I was about 18 or 19, and then there's a talent contest going, and I joined the talent contest and I won all the heats, and the prize was a recording contract with the local record company, and that's where my recording career began. There was a producer that happened to be down in Zimbabwe on holiday, and he saw one of my videos on TV, and he's like, oh, you know, I'd like her to come down. I think she's got a good voice. And one of my friends worked at one of the biggest radio stations, and he believed in me. And the three of them, including my record label in Zimbabwe, all put some money together, you know, God bless them all, and bought me a ticket to come to the UK to record stuff in Wolverhampton, actually. And we were sending it round to record labels, trying to get a record deal. And, you know, one of those fell on the lap of the Band of Gypsies, Tim and Nigel, who loved my voice. And, you know, I got to meet in with them. They asked me what I want to do. What am I looking at? I said, look, I want tracks that are uplifting. They've got a good bass line that, you know, when people hear them, I want them to feel they can stand up and dance if they want to, or clap their hands or tap their feet. And more importantly, I wanted lyrics that were positive.
Yeah.
You know, and so if you listen to the whole Everybody's Free album, it's real life positive stories, you know. Yeah. and that's what the guy managed to achieve for me.
Wow. It is certainly you can't go, there's no album, there's no mix, there's no whatever. You if you say 90s, that is one of the ones that comes from. And it must be such a great fit. I mean, have you ever been anywhere where they've not recognized you and it's been on? That's my question.
I don't know. I think I would sort of hide my face. So nobody recognizes me. And I mean, it probably used to happen in the earlier days when my videos were played on MTV and they were played everywhere. You know, I get recognized on the tubes when I, you know, catch the tube, stuff like that. I get recognized when I was walking up and down Oxford Street. And I have to say, as flattering as that was, it was quite disconcerting. And I didn't really like that aspect of it. You know, it was a bit like, oh, I'm being watched. so that part was, a bit weird for me. But fast forward to now, I don't get recognized. And that is absolutely fine by me. Occasionally I do, which comes as quite a shock. You know, like I think it was a few weeks ago, I was standing in Marks and Spencer's and some lady tapped me on the shoulder and I thought she was going to ask me where, what is, you know, in the grocery store. And I said, yes. And she went, you're that singer that used to sing. She says, used to sing. And you did Everybody's Free. I remember you. Are you still singing? I'm like, yeah. So that just totally throws me. But I find it, you know, it's very flattering, you know, it's very uplifting. And so far, you know, I don't really get recognized much, but apart from when I do my gigs, and then, of course, the people are expecting me to be there and to come on stage, and that's where the hardcore Rozalla fans are. So, yeah.
How have you found the reception? Obviously, working on a new album, which is great, and we can't wait to get it. What has the reception been like for you coming back into it? Because you've never really gone away, have you? But now you're sort of pushing a new song, and the reaction, obviously, it's a little bit different because you'd have to do things on Zoom, you're not going to radio stations and all that. So the reaction from people, now you've got something new out, what are people receiving it well, or are they is it mediocre? We love it. I mean, we've got it on the playlist on Flashback Radio.
And oh,
we,
thank you.
We love it. And it's one. It's on. I think he's going to tell me in my ear now. But I think it's on 3 times an hour.
Ooh, that is incredible. Thank you so much. Yeah. I have to say, Pete, we released it on Monday. You know, and you know, before that, we started sort of getting it out and promoting it and sending it to DJs and stuff like that. The feedback so far has been brilliant. I mean, you know, it's currently at number 18 on the iTunes vocal chart.
Wow.
There's a promoter in America. They go by the name of Kings of Spin, and they send it around to all the stations. It's just coming today that it was voted by their DJs in their top 30, and it's at number 2. So, you know, the feedback has been just incredible. Absolutely wonderful, really. Yeah.
Well, that's really good. That's really good to know, because you are a legend, of course. You are a legend. It's only fair to give you the respect that you're due.
Thank you. Honestly, thank you.
So how many songs are you through in the production of the new album? When can we expect it? Come on, tell me.
Let me tell you, with this lockdown, things have been a case of stop, start. Not sure where to go, not sure what to do. But fortunately, you know, Gary and I were thinking we'd have about between 12 to 15 tracks on the CD. And when we last counted, we got another 2 more tracks left to record. So we're still out there looking for songs. We've got a couple that we think will be suitable. And then the rest of the other singles are being mixed currently, and that's how we were able to, you know, put the follow-up to Magnificent out, which is I Feel It Slipping Away. And we've probably got another 2 more or several more, I don't know, it depends on what mixes come back, to release before the album is due out in 2021. So basically it's just bidding us time. And you know, and hopefully, please God, if, you know, I Feel It Slipping Away is out there for a few months, it bids us the time for me to go into the studio and work on the other songs and the album without having to rush it.
Well, fair play to you for keeping going, because I know a lot of music producers and that are all sat with their feet up, not doing a great deal at the moment. But fair play to you, because you're doing it, you're out there, and the song is great. You know, this current one is
a real,
and I would assume that it will enter into the chart on Friday as well, which I think will be cool. Is that a noise coming from you? Oh, hello. We're losing your signal. You disappeared then for just a second, but you're back now, so that's okay. All right. Well, look, brilliant. I really appreciate you coming on the show. I really, I'm one of your biggest fans. You know that. We've done stuff together on the sort of Butlins.
I know that, my darling. And I'm your big fan too, and I follow you. And I just want to say my biggest heart thank you to you, Pete. Really, thank you.
No, you're very welcome. You're very welcome. Thank you so much for coming on the show. And hopefully we'll get you on again. And we're going to take a break over the Christmas period. And then we're coming back in January. But I'd love to get, when the album comes out, I would love to get you back on and get some more tracks from you and get you going that way. Because I think that would be fantastic.
And what would be even better is for me to come into your studio in person and we can do this album thing together. That would be amazing.
Ah, well, I've got one question for you. Do you have any, obviously, when lockdown is finished, have you got any plans to do any festivals or anybody talking to you about doing anything? Because I'm sure the people...
Definitely. I've got some stuff in the diary already. You know, I had about 70 dates in my diary for across this year that have been, some have been moved to next year, some have been cancelled. But we've got some stuff starting in March, but it's all a wait and see game. But we have some stuff out there, and definitely there'll be some live gigs that I'll be doing in the new year for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we're on about doing some online live gigs as well to replace some of the ones that we've missed and get some of the artists on. So we'll be talking to you about that and get you on there as well. That'd be great.
I would love that. I would love that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the legend that is Rozalla. Give her a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Rozalla, thank you so much. Thank you so much. And don't forget, it's slipping away. Rozalla's brand new single is out now. Download it. Let's get it to the top of the charts. And we're going to play that snippet one more time before we say goodbye to Rozalla. Rozalla, thank you, honey. Thank you.
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
Yes, 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 yes. Brilliant.
Thank you, darling. I can't see. I've lost you for some reason.
I'm back now. Thank you very much, Rozalla. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, Pete, my love. Just take care and Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas to you too. Have fun. See you soon.
Thank you, my darling. God bless.
Bye-bye. That's Rozalla, ladies and gentlemen. Right, we're going to take a little break now and we'll be right back after this.
Give me some directions to get to you, to get to you. Ain't gonna waste my time. I know that we got connection. I think about you. You're on my mind, on my mind, on my mind. Yeah, I'm going out of my mind, out of my mind, out of my mind. Yeah, for you, my love. Tell me what to do, I'm on my knees, yeah, I am begging you, begging you. I'll break the rules if it will get me to, yeah. get you out of my mind. I can't live without your love for sure. You drive me crazy, tell me what to do, what to do. I'm on my knees, yeah, I am begging you.
You see now, I love that record, but it's not like a record that has been around anywhere. It's one of those ones you can play and you don't get muted for playing it, which is just brilliant. Anyway, if you just joined us, good evening, welcome to the show. It is late tonight. My name's Pete Sheriff, and we every week for a season, and a season is like 7 episodes. We chat, we talk, we have some guests on. You've seen the lovely Rozalla was with us a couple of weeks ago. Pat Sharp was with us. Dennis from Musical Youth has been on. Who else have we had? We had Gavin James on, DJ Gavin James, an all-round super agent. And we get me and my mates, they come on and talk to me. And we've got one of them on the line right now. And we're going to have a discussion. And let me warn you now, him and I have discussions that go anywhere. They could go anywhere. So be prepared. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Mr. Matt Bullock. Good evening, sir.
There's so much I could pick up on there. Seasons. You're not in the States, man.
It's a season. Everyone's on about seasons now. How are you?
I'm fine. I've got my Christmas t-shirt
camera
on.
Fell over.
The what? No, I've only just jumped in.
How have you? Where you been?
Oh, working. I do have a Christmas t-shirt on.
Oh, there you are. Is that a Coca-Cola Christmas t-shirt?
It certainly is.
Does it have a truck on the back?
No, it doesn't. Or the front. It's just got Father Christmas.
You have to say happy holidays.
Happy holidays, because you're not allowed to say anything else in the States. But anyway, yeah, so how was Rozalla? Sorry, I wasn't around.
Where were you? What have you been doing?
I've been working. Oh, my God.
You've been keeping Mrs. Bullock happy again?
No. No, I've got to. You've only got me for 15 minutes because I've got to sort her out. So, dinner.
Oh.
Dinner. I've got to sort her out.
You were so close to getting a U rating then. I mean, now you just took it up to a 15.
There's nothing wrong with that. That's fine.
You've got to go and sort your
mission. I don't need my glasses on so far.
You don't need to see nothing. Oh, yeah, you do. No. You probably need them in a minute, though.
Oh, do I?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I've got some. You know, you and I have known each other for a long time, and we've been talking, and every year we get to this point, but we never do it on the air.
What, so Christmas?
Christmas gifts. What are you thinking? Because you're normally pretty good with your Christmas gift, and you can work out what you're going to get. And so far, I think you're quite accurate, aren't you?
I am. I'm sure. I've just... Hang on a second. Bear with me. Catherine!
Oh, no.
You're dimming my screen.
What's going on?
You've just dimmed my screen.
Hey, what?
It's all right. She's got... Oh, it's confusing. Shall I start? Shall I start?
Go on, then. Right.
So obviously, you know that there's a new MacBook coming.
Yes.
Which is coming on the 9th, I've now been told.
I think so, Pete has been sick, by the way, but go on.
Why? Oh, he does not Mac, does he?
No.
So we've got... this Mac... Hey, eh?
What's going on? Come on, get on with it.
I'm telling a story.
Oh, I'm trying
to set the story up.
Oh, okay. I'll sit back in my chair then. Go on.
Yeah, that's all right. I mean, you've only got I only can see 4 viewers, but that's fine.
That's on that platform. You want to see them over there?
Same excuse I use. But so she's got a really old MacBook. This MacBook Air is going to her because what she did, she spilled a glass of water into her old MacBook.
Right.
So the keyboard screwed up. So I then gave her one of the many Mac Bluetooth keyboards I have lying around here. I don't know why. I've collected those.
Yeah.
Which is still connected to my MacBook. So she's just dimmed her MacBook and it's dimmed mine.
Is that me? So
I'm just disconnecting
your keyboard and she's dimming your screen.
That's right. And now I've just got to figure out how to... There we go. That's it. That'll go.
What is that noise? Is that you?
The buzzing noise?
Yeah.
That's that noise. That's not me.
That's a weird noise. Oh, well. Anyway.
Is it coming from my end? Let me just mute me.
It's him, isn't it? It is him because it's gone now. Look, he's muted, and the sound has gone. So now we know it's him. We know. Everybody knows, right? So anyway, Matt, we know. Yes, it is you.
I have nothing connected with. I've literally just got the microphone plugged in. No power. Nothing. I disconnected me Earth, as Mr. Gibson said.
Yes.
And now I'm living on the danger of being killed at any point. Thanks, Pete. Anyway, not you, Pete.
Can we get on with this?
It's all right. This is entertaining. All right. Let me just see. Is that what's happening there? Yeah,
that's Matt. You sound like you've turned a squelch up on a flipping CB radio.
So that's worse then.
That's worse now.
What about that?
That's worse.
Let's just leave it at that then.
I'm not in the doctors.
That's all right. Just say are. So, anyway. Right.
Yeah.
Not Mandalorian. Oh, what have I done there?
You got your new phone. Is this what I've not heard
tomorrow
today? Because you've been...
tomorrow. It's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Coming tomorrow, yeah. So, I'm spending a small frigging fortune with Apple this week. Yeah, thank you very much, Apple. Christmas wise, I've requested the iRobot Roomba. Is it Roomba?
The vacuum cleaner thing.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
For our hard floor in the kitchen.
Okay.
And that's it. That's all I've requested because we're having, we can call the show on 0121. Oh, that's not for me. Because we're having that fireplace fitted as well. This is interesting for people.
It's around your house, isn't it?
It is.
Flipping heck.
That's why I can't speak to you all the time.
Well, standard. So, Christmas gifts. I don't know what I'm getting. Hopefully a new camera, I think. Might be.
What's the matter with that one, then?
This is a webcam, but my GoPro seems to have melted inside tonight.
Ooh.
It just went, nope, not doing it anymore, not playing. Ta-ra!
You didn't disconnect your Earth, did you? Like Pete told you to. No.
No. However, I do have some suggestions that you might be able to get for your lady. Well, I've got one for your lady wife here, mate. Here's a suggestion for you. How about getting some spreadable gin? There we go. Where is it? It's got this picture here. Look, there we go. Spreadable gin. How's about that? Gin and tonic marmalade. Tonic
marmalade.
That'll be all right for your missus. Look, mate, that'll be all right. Keep her quiet.
Do they do a tonic version as well? Is like gin, marmalade, and tonic.
I think that's got all three in there.
All at the same time?
Yes. Gin, tonic, and marmalade.
Well, that's me out because I don't like tonic water.
You're not a fever. It's not Fever Tree esque round by you then.
No, lemonade here.
Lemonade.
Gin and lemonade. It's an old fashioned drink and it's actually called something. Oh, I saw it on a program the other day. They called it gin and lemonade. They called it a certain name.
Okay. If you know what it's called, call 318
86888.
I'm talking
just read your screen. It says it on the screen.
I'm looking at the camera. The camera's there. The screen's over there. So I'm presenting. Anyway, let's move on. Here's something for you. So, because now the thing is with Matt, me and him will talk on the phone for hours. I found a perfect gift that you can sit in the living room, right?
Yeah.
You can watch telly and me and you can talk and discuss Mandalorian while your missus is doing whatever she does in the corner. Right. So check this out.
What's that? That is one of your weird S&M parties. That's
no, it's a mouth guard where you can talk and listen and no one can see what you're talking about. It's a secrecy, privacy chat helmet.
Well, that's not gonna, it's gonna sound like that.
Well, I don't know.
You're gonna sound like Bane from Batman. Oh, you know what? No, don't. I wasn't even going down Darth Vader. No. Hello, it's me, Bane. On every single phone call. That's not going
to do it. Right. Now I understand.
You stand up and walk out the room and say you're on a business call, like I've said now.
Okay. Well, let's move on. Do you ever watch Dr. Pimple Popper?
no, no, I don't want to see this.
Do you know Dr. Pimple?
No, no, I don't want to see it. No, if you put it on, I'll have to just
No,
if you want to put it on.
But what I'm saying is, if you're a fan of Dr. Pimple Popper, this
no, I'm not.
Is your perfect Christmas gift, right? Check this out. Look at that.
What is it?
Look at that. It's a thing.
What's wrong with their nails?
Well, the reason I did think that when I was like,
I mean, they're perfectly manicured, but then the whatever that part is below where the other bit is, why is it black?
That's clear. If that's a woman's hand, you have a woman's hand, my lord. No,
those are bloke's hands.
That's a bloke's hand. So, what manicurist is he going to?
I don't know. It's like he's manicured it, forgot to clean his nails.
It's just wrong. Wrong, wrong, wrong. So does
not that. Not a tree. Not work out how old he is, but those lines. Disgusting. Why would you put that on? You didn't show that Rozalla, did you? Oh, no.
Rozalla's royalty, mate. Royal 90.
Yeah, you wouldn't show a pimple popper.
Obviously, he's got her own problems, mate.
Do you want have a look at this for Christmas, Rozalla. I don't know how you interviewed him. I do apologise, but...
There's a personal sauna if you fancy it. Now, for some reason,
if this is just a black bag you get into with a hairdryer, I don't want to know.
It's not. I couldn't fit the whole thing on the screen for some reason.
But you just reduce it.
Yeah, oh, I did.
It's not far off of what I said. That's a black bag with a hairdryer inside of that.
But the looking at it, surely the intention is for it, because it says the caption is a portable sauna. Who's taking that out with them? You're just going to sit at the bus stop with that on?
Well, I mean, if me or you went in that after about an hour, that'd be a swimming pool inside that.
Yeah, but
it'd be a portable swimming pool.
Think how thin
you are. It's just a bag of sweat. Excuse me, whose bag of sweat is this? It's not a bag of sweat, it's a portable sauna, sir.
For you.
Pardon, what was that?
I've got two more for you.
Oh, okay.
Okay, right. One of them is for the golf course. Because you know.
Oh, yeah, because I'm always on the golf course.
Well, you've played golf, haven't you?
No. Pit and put at the Wood End Park, but that's about it.
Is that still open?
I don't think so now. I think it's a nuclear bunker now. But anyway.
It could be. That could be where they're keeping those flipping silver things. What? Now, we'll come on to the silver things.
Come on to the silver things in a minute. You've got 10 minutes of me left. Come
okay, on. That's fine. So, I get caught short on the golf course. This could be a perfect Christmas gift for anybody who plays golf but has got a weak bladder. There you are. It is a...
I don't know what I'm looking at.
You can't see all the picture, which is unfortunate.
What do you know about cropping?
No, listen, mate. I don't know. I don't know what's happening.
What is it though? It just looks like a very thick golf stick.
It's got a
golf club. Can't call them sticks; they get very angry. I found that out.
What?
You can't call them sticks; they're golf clubs because golfers get very, very angry. I don't know what's the matter with them. Don't call it just stick, it's a club. All right. Calm down.
Now you said about cropping the picture. I want to crop this one because I don't want you to miss it. So hold on.
Can I just say, really, you don't, it's two presents in one is that sauna thing, because you can have a quick whiz in there, you can have a sweat, and no one's going to get any difference. So take that in the golf course.
Do you reckon?
I think so.
Yeah, but then
you just load it on the back of a little buggy. You'll be fine, that little sauna thing. I'm taken by that sauna. I like that.
You're going to stand in your own stuff, though, aren't you, surely?
It's perfectly clean.
Ooh, isn't it? He's gone again. You keep disappearing.
Do I? Am I back now?
Yeah, you're back now.
I can hear that feedback now. That's how I sound.
Yeah. You got that weird noise going on.
What's DJ Gracie saying there?
I don't know. DJ Gracie in the house. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Okay, well, I can load my other
picture. No, she's saying hello to Dr. Illusion. DJ Illusion.
Dr. Illusion? I'm not letting you anywhere near anything. So if you don't know, ladies and gentlemen, we've got a new presenter coming up on Flashback Radio very soon. His name is DJ Illusion. He's on after the Soul Selection on a Sunday.
Have I just let this out the bag?
No, it's on the website. You put it on the website. So, Mr. Webmaster.
Dr. Illusion.
His name's not Dr. Illusion. He's DJ Illusion. What's his first name?
I don't know what his first name is. Is it a joke?
Use your imagination. What's his first
just
name?
Just an illusion. I thought we weren't supposed to talk about this.
No, we're not. But you're such an idiot.
Just an illusion. You know what the funniest thing was? When you were texting me saying about loading this stuff on the website, and you said DJ Illusion, and I thought, that's great. It's a good DJ name. It's a solid DJ name, Mr. Illusion. It is proper solid. But when I was texting back, I don't know where to go with this.
Where was this going?
I put a lyric in, just an illusion, you see. That's what I thought. But then when I typed it, I thought, hang on a minute, Justin.
What? You didn't.
I wrote the joke without actually realizing I was writing the joke. How about that? You know, how good am I?
That's what happened with Morecambe and Wise.
Just an illusion. Dr. Illusion. I like Dr. Illusion.
I think Pete's passed out because he's like, oh my God. So, ladies and gentlemen, we've got one more Christmas gift, and
six
it's
minutes.
Especially what?
It's 6 minutes. The numbers are going up this end.
I know. So we're going to do one more Christmas gift before we finish the show because you can't stop laughing.
Can I just go on to these?
What? I don't know.
I don't like that buzzing noise. I'm quite upset by that. But Pete, you have to sort this out.
Now you're getting the blame, Producer Pete.
Yeah, I'm just switching over to...
That's all right. That's all right.
Hello?
Hello. There you go. That's nice. That's lovely. Now you sound like you're in the toilet. Take the computer, go downstairs and sit in the toilet.
No, I'm not doing that. What's downstairs? Where do you live?
I never go upstairs.
Upstairs toilet. That's weird. Is that rubbish now then?
That's all right. It's fine. So
you know me, I like to be perfect. I host the tentpole shows of the week, so I have to.
What shows do you host the tentpole one of the week?
It's Anthems of the Future on a Monday night, and a Saturday evening as well, and obviously at the house party on a Friday at 7 o'clock.
Yes, are you back on live this week? Are you?
We're still doing it. We're carrying on. Don't know what's happening.
You'll be doing that till March, mate. That's what's going on there.
I'm not doing it till March.
Anyway, one more. I've got one more Christmas gift, and then we'll move on.
Come on, one more Christmas gift.
This will probably finish you off. To be fair, so.
I can switch.
How's that sounding now?
Awful. Back to the headphones.
These are the headphones now.
What was that before then?
The computer.
Oh, now you've got a delay going on. And everything. Are those your AirPods?
It's all going off. No, that's my microphone
that's
again.
That's all right. Now. Okay, well, whatever. We haven't got longer the show to go.
I know. Well, I'm just filling time, mate.
So can we get...
You've got 15 minutes. Right, you've only got one thing. Here we go.
I've got one more thing left to do, and then we can go. We can go for
a bit.
I'm
really excited. No, we can't. We can't go anywhere.
Well, we can go and stand in the garden.
We can go to Worcester. Worcestershire, which is just past Earls, we can get a pub there.
Well, Al Rippin was on the phone to me the other day, and he's going, I don't live in Birmingham. There's a pub open at the end of my street.
Well, where's he live?
Out there somewhere.
Licky Hills?
Something, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, they're in Worcestershire, yeah.
That's right. That's nice. Go have a G&T for me, won't you? Thank you.
I mean, you know Ellswood Lakes?
Yes.
That's where the line is by us. That's Worcestershire. Didn't even know that. Anyway, carry on.
Can I do this last gift?
Okay, yeah. Because this is perfect timing there. 8:47.
8:47. It just sound like you Moyles in the morning doing the breakfast show. And he's talking about it, so he goes, 8:47. So anyway,
I've he got only says one... the time so they can go back and do the clip. That's, you know that, don't you?
Oh, is that what it is?
That's, he says the time because he doesn't do time checks normally. But if he just suddenly goes 8:47, that means his producer writes the time down, and that's the bit they'll clip.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I do this last gift now, please, for the love of God?
I bet you better be good now. I've built it up.
So, Christmas stocking on your you know, you put your stocking up for Santa to put his gifts in, and you never know, it's sweets, they put sweets in there. In the old
day,
they used to put coal in there, you know. Boy,
and now, orange.
And an orange. You had an orange, a lump of coal, and some pegs to play with. Mm-hmm. But now they've updated the sweets. And this is something that I think you should get. Get your wife to buy you some breast milk lollipops.
Bro, no.
Hey, get some of them on the go.
No. No, I've got a story here.
Have you? Is this okay on the air before 9 o'clock?
Accidentally drank some breast milk once. It was in the fridge.
Hey! The fact why? What?
I don't know how it worked. I don't know what happened. Put it in my coffee.
I don't know how it works.
I know how it works. But obviously, you know, you can, if you're going out for the evening and you've got children, and the wife is breastfeeding, so she can have one of those things.
A breast pump.
That's the one. I didn't want to actually say it, but then actually doing the noise is worse. And it was in a jug. We had excess, and so put it in a jug. And
excess. What?
let's not get down there. And put it in my coffee the following morning. It was horrible. That's it. Yeah, I feel real now.
Yeah, like Pete just said, jugs, really?
It's a strange place to keep your jugs, lady.
Oh, man. I haven't done a title, an end credit sequence to this episode because I wasn't sure whether you were coming on or not. So I didn't.
What's that mean?
No. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Anyway, ladies.
Like you watch everything I do.
Of course I do. I watch every move just in case.
I talked to you yesterday. Was it Monday? And you're not. What are you doing the show? My 12 o'clock news business show.
Oh, don't watch that.
That finished?
Oh, no.
That's
no.
Funny, though.
No. Right.
No.
Right. I like it. And then you drift off on a tangent every so often. So I go.
I can share a screen here. How do we know that? I know. I would have showed you something, but it doesn't matter. I'll do that next time.
Come on.
No, I can't because it was the stuff I did on the show last week on Friday because it was funny. But we won't go to it. Too late. No, 10-2. I've got to go.
Okay. Well, thank you. And I think I'll call you tomorrow.
Please do.
DJ Illusion's talking now. Hang on.
Thank you. I don't read the message.
I thought he was going to pull you.
Series, come on. What's he putting? Hey, yeah. Sorry, I didn't see this among all the other messages. It's all right. No, it's all right. It's all right. The doctor's fine.
Oh, God. Well, from me, Pete Sheriff, thank you so much for watching. From Matt Bullock, thank you. And,
keep it random.
We'll be back in January. And let me tell you before we go. No, it's Christmas break, mate. Let me tell you before we go, our next season on Late Tonight, we've got... Black Legend. We've got
some new writers.
Black Legend.
We've got some new writers and producers.
Entrance.
Black Legend.
Yeah.
Entrance.
Oh, man.
I'm just repeating what you're saying, actually, just to make it sound better.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching.
You've got ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, God, I'm going to get rid of him. Oh, God, he's just been there forever. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be back in January. It's been emotional. Have a great Christmas, a great new year. Stay safe, wear a mask, wash your hands, and all that stuff. We'll see you on the other side. Bye.